This video is in response to a viewer that asked, what's the difference between a husky and a malamute? Both Bonnie and Clyde think huskies are way cooler than malamutes, but they might be a little biased. Certain breeds of dogs are easy to confuse, and this is certainly the case with the Alaskan Malamute and the Siberian Husky. Both breeds are recognized by the American Kennel Club, and both look kind of similar to a wolf. The Alaskan Malamute, the Siberian Husky, and the Alaskan Husky may resemble each other, but there are quite a few differences. When you first set your eyes on the Alaskan Malamute, the first thing that will strike you is their sheer size and presence. It's also a little easy to confuse them for a wolf. The Malamute is much larger and easily dwarfs the smaller Husky when you stand them side by side. The Siberian Husky is one of the oldest dog breeds on the planet and was first bred by the Chukchi people in eastern Siberia. Both breeds are among the oldest known dog breeds and have very long histories as sled dogs in very cold and harsh climates. Like the Siberian Husky, Malamutes are incredibly loyal dogs and will happily spend all of their time with their human family. Huskies are a little more sociable, lighter in weight, and more free-spirited than the larger Malamute. While both were bred to work alongside their human companions in the cold wilderness, the Malamute was bred to haul weight, while the Husky was bred to race and run fast. The Malamute more often worked alone, whereas the Husky would work in teams of multiple dogs. Siberian Huskies are medium-sized work dogs, and they're known for their intelligence and independence. They're still very affectionate, but not quite as particularly needy. Although their intelligence and ability to learn is remarkable, Huskies are notoriously difficult to train and can easily get bored, so they are best with confident, experienced dog owners. A male Malamute stands at 25 inches tall and weighs between 85 and 100 pounds. Females are slightly shorter at about 23 inches and weigh around 75 pounds. Like the Husky, they have a dense double coat. The outer coat, referred to as the guard coat, is short and coarse, whereas the undercoat is around 2 inches deep and oily and woolly. This helps wick away the wetness and keeps them warm in cold weather. In terms of color, it can range all the way from black, light gray, all the way through various shades of red. Regardless of the color of the top of their coat, their underbelly will mainly be white along with the markings on their face, legs, and paws. The Siberian Husky did not reach the United States until 1909, and it took until 1930 to become recognized by the American Kennel Club. Of course, each dog's individual personality is different. Malamutes tend to need more human affection, whereas Huskies tend to be a little bit more independent. Also, the Huskies have much more independent mindset and will choose to listen to their humans' commands if, and only if, they actually want to listen. They are both very lovable, fluffy giants. Each breed has their own unique traits, making them more or less suited depending on your requirements for a home pet. One thing is for sure, they are very demanding dogs and require a responsible owner who has the time needed to train and exercise them. Without a high level of exercise, both breeds can turn to destructive behavior out of boredom. Many parents are concerned about the guarding tendencies. The difference is especially important if you are choosing a dog to be around your children. Huskies make great family pets and are great around children. They are also usually pretty good in multi-dog households. If raised with other animals as a puppy, Huskies can live in multi-pet households too. Huskies have a very strong prey drive, however, and they tend to attack smaller animals like squirrels, rabbits, and sometimes cats. But if they're raised around other animals from puppyhood, they should be fine. Malamutes can also make great family pets and are great with children. The only downside is their larger size, and their high energy means that sometimes they will overpower a small child accidentally. So they're best for households with children that are over the age of 5. They also thrive in multi-dog and multi-pet households, once again, as long as they're raised from puppy. However, they're often considered too people friendly and outgoing to make them good guard dogs. Both the Alaskan Malamute and the Husky are both very smart and very expert escape artists. Plus, they can jump or dig through areas that are not very well dog-proofed. Thank you for watching this video. I hope it was helpful. Please make sure you hit the like and subscribe button because that makes Clyde really happy. Right, buddy?